Today's webinar is dedicated to overeating. The pleasure that we receive from eating food that we enjoy can be a perfect tool to suppress our emotions. We start eating more and more. When we eat, we feel better. Food eases the pain, but it can ease the pain only for a short period of time. Once the pain comes back, we need to eat again and again and again. This all happens subconsciously. Our brain substitutes one feeling for the other without us even being aware of it. When we feel sad, we want to eat something sweet that will make us happy. When we feel tired, we want to eat chocolate or candy to get energy. When a husband comes home angry after work, a wife can say, "Calm down, honey, eat your dinner and relax." In this example, food is being used to suppress anger. Food helps us to deal with lack of love, with feelings of sadness, anger, anxiety, tiredness, and stress. Today we are talking about how food can compensate for the lack of love. We will discuss in detail how other emotions are connected to food on the next webinar entitled Food and Emotions. Tell me what you eat and I will tell you what problems you have. Please find the link to that webinar in the description of this video. If you like this video so far, please give me a thumbs up and consider subscribing to my channel. Please share this video on your social media with your friends and family members, with your partners, and with your loved ones. Let's get back to the topic. Why dieting doesn't work? Why people gain even more weight after dieting? Food is the easiest way to compensate for the lack of love. Therefore, if we did not receive enough love in our childhood and do not receive enough love now in our current relationship, then we will use food as our coping mechanism. When we have cravings for love and there is nobody who can give us enough love, care, enough support, we will use food as a substitute. Therefore, diet and exercise will never work alone. In our life, we possess several love containers. We receive one from each of our parents. One parent cannot fulfill the container of the other parent. For example, if your father was absent and your mother loved you unconditionally, this is still not enough. Your mother cannot replace the missing love for your father's container. Your partner, your children, your friends, or your pets cannot replace the missing love either. These are different types of love and different types of relationships. Often people try different diets and sport activities. They blame personal coaches and nutritionists for their failures. The truth is, if your inner love container is empty, diet and exercise won't help you to lose weight. A person with a strong willpower can lose weight, but if his psychological issues are not healed, then he will be drawn to food again. His willpower might falter in a stressful situation.